What makes Muhammad a prophet? That's the question we ask.
Everything that makes Moses, Jesus, David a prophet. Same thing. Give me one thing Muhammad has and they don't have, and we'll talk about it.
One, first of all, we don't believe David was a prophet. We believe Moses was a prophet.
Did he have a book?
One second. We believe Moses was a prophet and we believe Jesus.
Did David have a book? Okay. So now, for that reason, you gave me a standard. No, miracle and prophecy.
Both of these
I'm finishing. Both of these qualities can be found in David. And you said David is not a prophet. Okay. I'm asking why. He has both of these qualities. He has prophecy. He has miracles. Why is he not a prophet? And if he's not a prophet, how can Muhammad be a prophet?
If you give your okay.
If David has both these qualities, if you're not accepting David as a prophet, wait, if you are not accepting David as a prophet, okay. How on earth will you accept another man as a prophet?
Let's go to David. Okay. Show me the Bible where David's a prophet. Majority of people
are Muslims. Can I respond?
I'm standing. Is anyone Christian here? No. Okay, one Christian. How many? Okay. Two Christians. All the rest are Muslims. You have 30 Muslims. You're talking about witnesses. When you finish,
I'll respond.
So the question is, where does the Bible say David is a prophet?
Okay.
Show me.
Good question.
Acts 2:29-30. Fellow Israelites, I may say to you confidently of our ancestor David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Since he, David, was a prophet.